When you look at this corner,
yeah,
what emotions come to you?
So sad. So much remembrance. I just want justice, and that's all I'm asking for, justice.
Saheed Vassell's family says he didn't have to die. The 34-year-old father of one was shot 10 times by four NYPD officers who say they were responding to 911 calls about a man with a gun in the neighborhood. It ended up being a piece of metal.
They did not have to kill him. They did not have to kill Saheed.
After the shooting death, NYPD immediately released an edited video with stills showing Saheed pointing the metal object at people, but no footage of their actual confrontation has been released.
They want to paint a picture of him as if he was a bad person.
Saheed was a wonderful person. Saheed's so loving.
A Jamaican immigrant who came to the States as a child, Saheed suffered from bipolar disorder after the shooting death of his best friend in 2008. He has four brothers and five sisters, one who serves in the Navy, and flew immediately from Japan when she heard the news.
This shouldn't be the reason why I'm home. I shouldn't be here mourning the death of my brother, knowing, considering the way he was taken from us, I should be here celebrating with him, celebrating with my family.
But in the quickly gentrifying Crown Heights, Brooklyn neighborhood where Saheed grew up and is known by many, people want to know who would call the police on him.
Sweet person. Never bother anyone, always walking with his Bible, his beads. He goes sit in the back of the church. I mean, this blew my mind.
No, I don't think that was even called for. I could see one shot, but several shots?
Yeah, like really?
We're about to go to the barber shop where Saheed used to go. It's one of his favorite places. A lot of people knew him in that barber shop right here in Crown Heights, Brooklyn. So we're going to head over and talk to them.
He's like family to everybody in here, you know?
Yeah.
It's not disrespectful. Nobody respect him. Nobody love him.
Kevin Davis, a barber and longtime friend, witnessed the shooting.
No siren, no warning, nothing. Because it's an unmarked car. It's when they make the U-turn in the middle of the street, that's when I said, oh shit, the cops. And I know that is they saw him. I wasn't paying attention to him. I was looking at them, trying to get their attention. Like, yo, don't shoot. It's not a gun, you know? Mm-hmm. But then they start firing like that, you know, like, they start shooting. You know?
How does that make you feel to be like in your own neighborhood?
Yo, trust me, I cried like I had nightmares for days, man. Like, for real.
To Saheed supporters, they don't see a scary threat in that video. Just a loving man who would often dance for laughs in the barbershop or joke after grabbing a beer.
He's riding the fight.
I see cases where white people have guns and shit and they give them chance, right?
They
for cover and say, drop a weapon for like 2-3 minutes.
On Thursday, Saheed's family will host his funeral. Posters litter the neighborhood with details for the service.
To imagine that I'm going to bury my son. Oh God, it's hard.
The nearer it draws is the weaker I become. I'm looking at one thing. At this moment, you see me sitting here, his coffin going on in the grave.
As the street corner memorial grows and State's Attorney General Eric Schneiderman takes over the investigation, the question looms, will this case end in the same way many others have?
If you listen to his parents and listen to the community, then you would realize that this man didn't deserve to die like this by the hand of the NYPD. So I would beg of the Attorney General and Mr. Mayor, please seek justice for everyone who knows Saheed Vassell, because he was a good man.